Libertyville. Naperville North is in the third lane. Oak Park River Forest, as Bruce mentioned, in the fourth lane. Aurora Rosary, number five. Crystal Lake Central in the sixth lane. And in the seventh lane, three sisters, Kristen, Kendra, and Kyle from Schaumburg. And right now, it looks to be
Oak Park.
Oak Park indeed in lane number four, which will touch first on the backstroke and get a good lead on the breast.
The lead can change hands here depending on where the schools are the strongest. Kate Wendt is a qualifier. She's the third qualifier in the second qualifier in the backstroke this evening, and she got off to a great start here.
And the breaststroke, it continues to be Oak Park River Forest in the lead. They had the best qualifying time of this consolation heat last night, finishing in seventh place, and right now holding true to form. But the gap is narrowed a little bit as we work it to the third leg, the butterfly.
Rosary's picked up a little bit now, and this is where they should come a little bit even. Most of the teams have good freestylers, and they change the lead back and forth depending on the breaststroke and the backstroke.
And as they work it back towards the end of the butterfly, the last 25 yards, it is still Oak Park with a slight margin in lane four.
And they're off to a great start.
Oak Park, the freestyler, is Deb Simone. She has a good lead right now as she kicks into the final turn.
And a full body length lead here from this angle.
She still works it down. Closing in lane three, though, looks to be Naperville North. We're going to have a good finish between Oak Park River Forest and Naperville North. Oak Park River Forest touching first.
Yeah, J.J. Bonstreicher, she's the leading qualifier in the 1500, anchored that relay for Naperville North, and she closed the gap, but they had too much of a lead.
Oak Park River Forest from the start goes ahead, gets the lead early, and holds on to get the first victory in the consolation heat of the 200-yard medley relay.
This should be pretty exciting, this final heat.
1:51 even, the time for Oak Park River Forest. 1:51.2 far in lane three for Naperville North. So it was indeed a close finish. 1, 2, and 3, 1:52.25. That goes in lane five to Aurora Rosary. So they take ninth place as we set up for the next race. This is the championship of the 200-yard medley relay. In lane two, Deerfield. In lane three is the team from Naperville Central. St. Charles, the team to look for in lane four. They were 5 seconds better than anybody last night. Set a state record, which was 4 years old. That was in qualifying. Gretchen Verdone in the backstroke. You see her with her head shaved in half right there in lane four. She is an all-time, big-time performer. Watch for her to get the lead early on. Winnetka Nutrera is in lane five, followed by West Chicago, the winners a year ago. And in lane seven, the team from Hinsdale Central, which set a school best yesterday, led by Jennifer Steffen.
Gretchen threatened to shave her head. She really wants this and the also the backstroke. She's excited. She's a senior. Look for Gretchen here to get off to a great start, and then it's Nutrier will be trying to catch up from there. They've got the strongest breaststroker.
And Jenny Grable. The interesting thing about this race also, Bruce, is that there are two freshmen performing for St. Charles. For two freshmen to perform at the level that they did last night is outstanding.
They had a great meet, and they've got a real balanced team, youth and veterans.
And as you would imagine, Gretchen Verdone gets the early lead.
She's about the same as she was last night in the relay. She was 26-7 last night, and she's 26-7 today. Here comes Jenny Grable, though.
Watch her in lane five.
Boy, Jenny looks good.
The West Chicago team, which won it a year ago with a time of 1:48.68. They have three of the four swimmers returning in this year's relay. They lost their senior, though, Aaron Myers.
Look at Jenny. Jenny's caught up and then some. Kristen DeWide in the butterfly for Nutrier.
Also a strong performer.
Also a strong performer, and so is Amy Muntz from St. Charles. But Nutrier's taking charge here. Boy, they're swimming outstanding.
The state record is 1:48.11. We are at 1:25 as we reach the final leg.
This should be quite a finish. New Trier's got a sophomore in the end of this.
St. Charles and New Trier, the two that are battling big time right here in this race.
Laura Southwick.
Five right now, she has a slight lead.
Laura has to hold on. Look at this finish coming up here. Laura's got her head down. Same kind of finish as last night, but Laura wins it today.
What a finish indeed for New Trier High School. True to form, as we mentioned, St. Charles behind Gretchen got the early lead, and New Trier got the lead in the second leg, held on from there, Bruce.
Yeah, it was quite a finish. It's interesting that St. Charles will keep the state record even though they weren't the best qualifier. Finisher. Look at the finish here. Laura holding on for dear life. What a finish. Keeps that head down. And just as Tony Harper taught her, keeps her head down, holds her breath, and finishes hard. Nice job, Laura. And you can tell she was excited. I think she was a little disappointed last night, but winning the championship today.
148.80, your winning time. We'll take a break, come back with the award ceremony for the 200-yard medley relay, and also follow up with the 200-yard freestyle. That is coming up next.
Watch this finish here again. Strong finish by Laura Southwick, only a sophomore, and finishes hard. Look at JJ's trying to catch her, and she's off, but she keeps holding her off. Laura just keeps holding her off, and what a great finish by both of them.
0.08 of a second separate first place from second place. New Trier gained some valuable points. St. Charles, as I mentioned, set a state record last night. That will hold, but the champions are New Trier. Running it down from 12th place, Schaumburg, Libertyville. Crystal Lake Central takes 10th place, Aurora Rosary, Naperville North, Oak Park River Forest, as you saw the consolation heat winner. And then 6-1, Hinsdale Central finishes where they qualified at the number 6 position. Deerfield, Naperville Central, West Chicago Community, the defending champions from a year ago, St. Charles, who will hold their state record. And Winnetka New Trier wins our first event of the day, the 200-yard medley relay.
The key for New Trier on that were two real important things. Jenny Grable just swam an outstanding leg. She went 29 seconds in her breaststroke leg. And Laura Southwick in her job at the end there. What a nice job she did, too.
There you see some of the awards being handed out to New Trier. Their first of, they hope, many wins this afternoon as they try to knock Hinsdale Central off the throne, two-time defending champions. And these girls you see right here,
Jenny Swarson getting her award,
celebrating as a team, Bruce. Hope to celebrate as individuals later on this afternoon. New Trier, your 200-yard medley relay state champion, in a time of 1.48.80.
These are big-time points, 32 points for winning the relay as opposed to the individual events where they're only 16.
The state record set last night was 148.11. We move it on now to the 200-yard freestyle. Consolation heat comes your way first. Now, we'll set the lineup in lane 2 from Normal Community, Lindy Mercy. In lane 3, Colleen Smith, a very good performer a year ago from Hinsdale Central. Lane 4, Nicole Redmond, a senior from Oak Park River Forest. Lane 5 is Julie Bancroft, a senior from Springfield Southeast. Heather Potkin, a sophomore from Dunlap. And Heidi Ratschke, just a freshman, comes in lane 7.
How important it is for her to qualify this year and be in the finals. That'll really do her, really help her next year and the years to come. There's a lot of pressure on these girls in this meet. 700 people out here to 1,000 people watching, swimming their hearts out.
To Cole Redmond, the senior from Oak Park River Forest, 154.59 yesterday. I guess the question I need to ask you, Bruce, about this 200-yard freestyle event, is it a distance event now, or is it truly a sprint?
You know, back in the early 60s, it was a distance event. It's a sprint now. These girls know how to train. The coaches are more sophisticated. They work 5 hours a day. In the pool and in weight training, these girls know they're trained for this event, and it's a sprint now. You can watch, but just watch the way they swim. They're moving their arms fast. Their breathing pattern is, they're holding the breath. In the past, in the 60s, they used to hold their breath, or not hold their breath, they used to breathe every single stroke, as you find them doing in the distance events.
Looks too close almost to call right now as they are bunched up in lane 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2. Trailing lane 7 is the freshman Heidi Ratschke right now as they make the turn.
The seniors are doing well. In fact, Heather Potkin in lane 6, she's out. Looks like she's a little bit out in the lead. She was out in 55-6, although the rest of the field is starting to catch up. Colleen, her experience, she won this event 3 years ago, 2 years ago, and her experience is starting to show, and swimming for a team, Hinsdale Central, is really helping her as well.
For Colleen Smith, obviously a disappointment. She was not able to qualify for the finals yesterday, but a consolation victory, the best she can do. She would love to do that. She, the senior out of Hinsdale Central.
And she's swimming for the team now. She's a senior, and she's swimming for the team. The individual glory is not in this event for her. It's the team glory. What a thrill it will be if she can win this.
As they kick it one more time and bring it down the final length.
And you see the field has really gotten close now.
Hard to tell right now. Looks like lane 3, Colleen Smith. Lane 3 and lane 4, Colleen Smith and Nicole Redmond.
Tied.
Colleen tied, yes.
Tied it. Wow. Boy, I'm glad we have electronic timing.
Unbelievable. 155.02. A dead heat for the top position between Colleen Smith and Nicole Redmond. Third place goes in lane 5, Julie Bancroft, the senior from Springfield Southeast.
Wow. You don't see many ties when you do the timing to a hundredth of a second, but look, you'll be able to tell here from watching the finish that how they finish. And I'm sure most of our fans out there could pick either whoever they wanted to win to be the winner, but it's pretty obvious it was a tie.
I think you're exactly right. Thank God for electronics, huh? I would not want to be the judge who had to call that one. So a tie for first place in the consolation of the 200-yard freestyle event, event number 2 of our afternoon. We move it on to the finals, and they line up with the Hinsdale Central junior, Jennifer Steffen, in lane 2, the state record 149.67. That was set by Stacy Cassidy. She did it from Evanston in 83-84. There you see Jennifer Steffen, Hinsdale Central in lane 2. In lane 3, Kim Vender from Winnetka, New Trier. She dropped 3 seconds off her score last night. Kim DeCroy from Peoria, Richwoods comes in lane 4. She had the top time qualifying. Lisa Kuhl, her domination in the 100-yard butterfly is well known. Kim DeCroy in lane 4, as I mentioned. Lisa Kuhl is from Rockford-Guilford High School. She is a senior. Jamie White is in lane 6. And in lane 7, from Wheaton-Warrenville High School, Courtney Coleman, just a sophomore. Her qualifying time, 154.50.
This should be a heck of a race between Kim DeCroy from Peoria Richwood and Lisa Kuhl from Rockford Guilford. They swim against each other in the junior nationals and the national meets. And to be in the state meet as seniors ought to be really exciting.
Kim Vender will also compete a little bit later in the 500 freestyle event.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
And a clean start indeed for these young ladies here at New Trier High School. The IHSA 1992 Girls Swimming and Diving Championships.
Look at Lisa out now. Lane 5 there. That's Lisa Kuhl that's out there. She's going out after this. She's pretty excited about this. It kind of looked like she was holding back last night in the qualifying. Doesn't look like she's holding back now.
She had a time of 152.44 in the qualifying last night, Bruce. We talk about her. She's going for an unprecedented fourth straight win in the 100-yard butterfly. What does it take to have domination in two different events, two totally different strokes?
Excellent coaching, dedication, and lots of hard work.
She's showing that it does pay off right now. She has had a full body length as she makes the turn on the near side of the pool.
Well, Lisa's out in 52.3, and she is just swimming away from the field. She is totally dominating this field.
Kim DeCroy and Kim Vender in lanes 3 and 4. Right on stroke to stroke. Also in lane 6, Jamie White from Wheaton North performing well. But this race thus far belonging to Lisa Kuhl.
Lisa, I'm sure, has her eye on that state record. It's 149.67. our fans will be interested to see how she finishes up here. And she's on pace for a state record.
Lisa last night, just the 152.44. She has built it up into a one-woman race right now with the kick in the final leg.
All the fans are on their feet here. Everybody's anxious to see if Lisa's going to be able to set a state record in this event.
She's at 145 right now as she comes down to the touch. Gaining quickly in second place is Kim DeCroy.
Just a little bit
touching
short.
At 150.87 is lane five, Lisa Kuhl, the senior from Rockford.
She's not disappointed. You see that smile on her face. And I think that answers your question. Is it a sprint or is it a distance event? It's definitely a sprint.
What a fine performance in lane five, Lisa Kuhl. Second place goes to Kim DeCroy, the senior from Peoria Richwoods. Her time, 151.97. We'll come back, check out some of the awards, and our next event is the 200-yard individual medley. That's all after this. We are back. The 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships just completed the 200-yard freestyle, event number two of the day, and the official rundown. The results are in, and they look like this. In 12th place, the freshman Heidi Rajke from Pekin, Lindy Mercy from Normal Community comes in the 11th spot, Heather Potkin from Dunlap, Julie Bancroft number 9, Colleen Smith gets some valuable points for Hinsdale Central with an 8th place finish. She gains 5 points for the team, and Nicole Redman wins the consolation heat. And in the finals, Jennifer Steffen, also from Hinsdale Central, picks up some points. Courtney Coleman, Kim Vender, a fourth place finish for Winnetka Nutrier, Jamie White, Kim DeCroy, and Lisa Kuhl wins it from Rockford Guilford High School, a time of 150.87. Number one, your winner, Lisa Kuhl. She adds this state championship to her 3 that she has already earned in her fine swimming career in the 100-yard butterfly event. Lisa Kuhl from Rockford Guilford, your 200-yard freestyle champion for 1992.
I'm sure Lisa's on the block happy that she won this event, but her mind is on that butterfly.
Our next event, the consolation of the 200-yard IM, the individual medley, the butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and then freestyle.
This is a grueling event for the kids. It's hard to train for this. Each stroke takes a little bit different muscle group, and the strategy is pretty important here. You'll see the lead change back and forth depending on whether the girl's strong in butterfly or breaststroke. They're not usually real strong, as strong in all 4 strokes, but some of them are, and this is at this level. You see them work on those weak strokes, and this would be a pretty exciting race.
As you got a look at the starting grid just a moment ago, you'll notice 3 freshmen in lanes 2, 4, and 6 in today's race.
This is the starter. Take your mark.
The freshmen I speak of, Tawny Larm, a freshman from West Chicago Community. She is in lane 2. Amy Munns, just a freshman from St. Charles, in lane 4. She was the top qualifier of the consolation bracket yesterday. And Amanda Smiley from Barrington, just a freshman, 211.85 last night in qualifying. Right now, looks to be lane 4. And indeed, it is the freshman, Amy Munns, as they hit the first 50 yards and move it on to the back.
And Amy's a butterflyer, and that's why she takes the lead there. She swam butterfly in her medley relay, and that's why she takes the lead here. Now you can see the backstrokers coming to the fore, and it looks like, my guess would be that Ann Smiley is a breaststroker.
Doesn't take long to figure out the strengths of each individual swimmer. And as you mentioned, as we were about to start the race, Bruce, that is why you will see so many lead changes in this event.
That's right. And now it's Chris Mackey from Naperville Central. She's a backstroker. And she's taking the lead after the backstroke.
Is it a situation where you try not to lose the race on your weak stroke, or do you actually try to win it on your strongest stroke?
It's a combination of both. You don't want to lose it on your weak stroke, and they spend a lot of time in the pool practicing on those weaker strokes. But you also don't want to ignore your strengths. You've got to take advantage of your strengths.
Love to throw the fastball all the time if you got a 92-mile-an-hour heater, but you got to throw the curve once in a while or the batters are going to get used to it, right? Same principle.
That's right, and here's Amy back in the lead again.
As they work it to the final 50 yards in the freestyle.
Everybody better be a freestyler in this race too. And Amy back in the lead in the freestyle, and she's starting to pull away a little bit.
A little bit from lane five, Misty Lorich, the sophomore from Aurora Rosary. She looks to be in second place right now. Third place, lane three, Chris Mackey, the senior from Naperville Central. But as we come down to the touch, it looks like Amy Munns, a freshman, will repeat her performance of yesterday, a good qualifying and the winner of the consolation.
Ashley Sherman, just a little bit faster than yesterday, a freshman. Boy, she's going to be part of the class of the field next year. She isn't already.
She comes in a fine fashion, 210.02. Watch the end, finished off strong freestyle.
Yeah, it was a good, strong finish here. Remember, she was the leader in the butterfly, same muscle group in the freestyle. And she has time to get out of the pool and take a look at the rest of the people finish. What a finish.
So Amy Munns comes in first place. Misty Lorich, the sophomore from Aurora Rosary, 211.60 last night. She was a little bit behind that today, 212.41. And in the number three spot, all the way up to lane two, another freshman, Tawny Larm from West Chicago Community High School. And that sets us for the 200-yard individual medley, the championship. The state record, 203.96, set by Bridget Bowman of Glen Ellen, Glenbard West, and the 1986-87 finals.
This ought to be quite a race. You get to see Gretchen Bedorn again. She's easy to pick out now with that shaved head.
They wasted no time getting it started, so I will run through the grid for you right now. On the far lane, top of your screen, lane two is Wendy Geldner, the senior from Homewood Flossmoor. Jenny Grable, the state champion in the 100-yard breaststroke, comes in lane three. She's from New Trier High School, the 1990 winner. Amy Ann Canfey, check that. Decatur MacArthur, the defending champion. Gretchen Verdorn, that Bruce just talked about. Strong in the backstroke. She is from St. Charles and in lane five. You see Ann Canfey right there, the defending champion in lane four as she moves to the back. The rest of the field in lane six is Ellen Frauman, a junior from Deerfield. And Deidre Geisler, a senior from Palatine, a 208.62 in the 91 final, so she performed well last year.
Yeah, she sure did. And Ann has taken a strong lead now, but now we're in Gretchen Verdorn's strong stroke, the backstroke. But it looks like Ann's is holding her off. Here's where the lead changes a lot. We see in the breaststroke, and we'll see Jenny Grable and Ellen Fromm from Deerfield. They'll be pushing the lead now, pushing for the lead.
The versatility that has to be shown, the strength of all four strokes in this event, just amazing.
Yeah, look at Jenny Grable come up here. Now, she was in fourth place going into the breaststroke, and she's already caught up to Ann. She's about a half a second behind. Got quite a race going here.
Jenny Grable from New Trier High School in lane three, and Campy, the defending champion, Decatur MacArthur in lane four. They are neck to neck as they kick it into the freestyle, and it's an all-out sprint for 50 yards for the state championship right now. And it is definitely a two-person race. Third place right now looks to belong to lane five and Gretchen Verdorn, St. Charles High School.
Jenny gave it her all in the breaststroke. I think Ann's a little bit stronger in the freestyle here, and she's going to finish out ahead.
She got a strong kick.
Got a nice strong kick, and there's Jenny Grable, best time of her life, too.
Jenny Grable comes in with a fine performance, 204.91, but it is not good enough.
But it is a state record. Ann Campy, state record in the 200-yard individual medley with a time of 203.56.
Boy, and that's exactly exciting. Why Jenny Grable's big time of 204 and some change was not good enough. You watch them coming to the finish. What a fine performance from the senior Ann Campy as she sets the state record here this afternoon.
She looks right to the board and you can tell she is excited. What a race. Another state record. I think that's our fifth this year. This year's state meet.
Ann Campy, the state record. We'll come back, watch her get her award. Moving on to the 50-yard freestyle event after this. Mike Goldberg, Bruce Woodbury back here in Winnetka, Illinois. We are through three events of the 1992 championships. The 200-yard individual medley turned out to be a spectacular performance. Run it down from 12 to 1. Chandra Latou from Hinsdale Central. Where else? Naperville Central's Chris Mackey comes in number 11. In the 10th spot, Amanda Smiley from Barrington. Tana Larm, West Chicago, comes in third place of the consolation heat. Misty Lorich. And then Amy Munns, just a freshman from St. Charles High School, comes in the winning spot, the seventh place spot from the consolation heat. In the finals, a state record set by Ann Campfee. Sixth place, though, belonged to Deirdre Geisler. Wendy Geldner comes in fifth place. Ellen Frauman from Deerfield in the fourth spot. Gretchen Verdorn from St. Charles High School, number three. Number two, Jenny Grable from New Trier. As you mentioned, Bruce, she swims her best time ever at 204.91, but the state record busted by Ann Campfee. 1986-87, Bridget Bowman swam in 203.96. 0.40, the difference today, 203.56. Your new state record, and it belongs to the senior, Ann Campy from Decatur MacArthur High School.
That's Jenny Grable we see standing up there applauding Ann Campy. I'm sure she's applauding for the state record, but she also knows that Ann won't be back next year, and she will.
And a good show of sportsmanship right there. She leaves Decatur with a state championship record, 203.56.
Everybody on their feet in appreciation of what Anna has been able to accomplish today. Bridget Bowman, the former record holder, was quite a swimmer and dominated the state of Illinois in this event for 4 years when she was in high school, and Ann just crushed that record.
Next race, the all-out sprint, the 50-yard freestyle event. Consolation heat comes your way first, obviously. And they set down the brackets like this. In lane two, Joy Gallagher from Midlothian. Kathy Lang from St. Charles High School in lane three. Natalie Lorick from Hinsdale Central, lane four. In lane five, Kim Laughlin from Chicago Lane. Sarah Adams is in lane six. And Becky Hodgkin is in lane seven. She is Lake Park High School. The great story right here is in lane five, Kim Laughlin. She set a public record of 24.23 seconds, missed the finals by just 0.11 last night, Bruce.
She's had a great meet, and it's good for the city of Chicago. One of the comments she's made is, we don't have the training facilities that some of these suburban schools have.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
I think the statement is, we don't need them.
And she did qualify. We will see her a little bit later this afternoon in the 100-yard freestyle, the first public league performer, a female swimmer in history to do so. Right now, she's looking for the consolation championship. They work it back the final 25 yards, and we are too close to call it right here.
Yeah, I'd like to see you try to pick this one out. It kind of looks like Kathy Lang from St. Charles is up there, and
she gets it in lane three. Kathy Lang, just a freshman from St. Charles High School. 24.47 seconds in lane seven. Becky Hodgkin, the freshman from Roselle, comes in second place, 24.69. And in the third spot, in lane six, Sarah Adams. This one came down to the wire, a trio of freshmen.
You can just barely tell that Kathy at the top of your screen there is going to finish hard and finish it ahead of everybody else there. Her hand was a little bit high. I'm sure Jennifer Hay, her coach, would have liked to see her hand recover a little lower over the water. She would have gotten in there a little bit faster. But she's only a freshman. She's still learning, and she'll be back again next year as well.
The state record for this event is 23.15. Betsy Lynn from New Trier High School in 80-81. We are ready for the championship matchup. Lane two, Claudine Chow from Park Ridge, Maine East. Meredith Quast, a junior from Hinsdale Central in three. J.J. Bontranger, Naperville North, the young lady to watch. Marnie Record in five. In six is Breon Fowles, a freshman from McHenry High School. And Kristen Bellison, a senior from Rolling Meadows High School in lane seven.
Mr. Starter, take your mark. Stand up.
Yeah! They caught themselves. We haven't had a chance to mention, but at one false start and you are become a spectator, you're not allowed to false start. If you false start, you're out of the race.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
Watch lane
four. JJ got a great start.
A spectacular start. She set state best in the sectionals this year, qualified first in not only this event, but also the 100-yard freestyle event. They touch and come back to final 25.
Looks like JJ has a little bit of a lead here.
She has to hold off lane two, though. Claudine strong in lane two, and it's going to be a finish between two and four, and who will touch first? Indeed, the defending champion, J.J. Bontranger, 23.86 seconds. She is your state champion.
What a finish. You can see J.J. in the orange cap here with her finish. Notice her low recovery on the arms now. She's not lifting her arms up like we saw in the last heat. And if she stretches, so she finishes with a straight arm. A lot of girls would have taken another stroke there, but she had her arm straight. You want to finish with a straight arm as you reach for the wall.
There is your winner, J.J. Bontranger. Not a surprise, the senior from Naperville North. Wins it with a time of 23.86. We'll come back, get some more awards, and also get into the diving competition. After this timeout, it's High School Swimming on Sports Channel. As they work towards the turn in the final 25 yards, Bruce.
Coaches feel this race is a start, a turn, and a finish. And we had a great turn here. You can tell her that she comes off the wall, her head's up high, and that's another key to the success in the 50 freestyle, is a high head, high body position, strong leg kick, and watch this finish now. Again, straight arm finish. Looking quickly back at the clock to see how she finished. What a race.
There you see the results. Kim Laughlin in the 12th spot, Natalie Larrick from Hinsdale Central, Joy Gallagher, Mithlothian, Sarah Adams from Washington, Becky Hodgkin from Roselle Lake Park, and Kathy Lang wins the consolation from St. Charles High School. And 6-1. You see it right there, Hinsdale Central. That is a third last night, a six today. That is interesting in the points. We'll talk about that more. And your winner, of course, J.J. Bontranger, edging out Claudio Geo. And there you see your state champion. She performed very well with a time of 23.86. And she waves to the camera and takes home a state championship.
Nice job, J.J.
We talked about the points a little bit in lane three. The Hinsdale Central girl, Meredith Quast. Talk to us about the points, if you will, real quickly. A couple of surprises here early on, Bruce.
Well, one of the things that happened real early in the meet is New Trier finished first in the medley relay. Instead of getting the 26 they were predicted to get, they ended up with 32. So that's a plus six for them. In the 50 freestyle, Hinsdale Central was supposed to get 19 points based on their qualifying last night. And both their girls, even though they swam well, didn't do as well as they thought they were going to do. Instead of getting the 19, it looks like they've got about 11. So they lost another eight there. So there's some switching around. New Trier's gone up in some events, and in the medley relay and the IM based on Jenny's time, and Hinsdale's gone down a little bit. It's tightening up a little bit.
Be interesting to see what builds from here. We will come back, get into the diving championships. Event number 5 of 1992, coming up next. Welcome back. It is time for Event 5, the 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships, and that is indeed what we focus on right now, the diving championships. Down to 12 divers, 3 dives each, and this is a little different. Their qualifying dives last night go towards the final score, a little different from the swimming where we all started out at 0-0 today. Kelly Telschau from Palatine Fremd High School, she will dive first. Lydia Ball from Champaign Centennial will dive in the number 2 spot. The third diver today, watch her very closely. Just a freshman, Hannah Shin, she comes in with the top score from the qualifying dives of a night ago. Lauren Winger, a senior from Evanston Township. Laura Coleman from Champaign Centennial High School, she also a senior. And Marcy Pogowski from Glenview, Glenbrook South High School, 251 points in qualifying. Then from 7 to 12, Courtney Shell, also of Glenbrook South. Kim Delicato from Galesburg, she is in the number 8 spot diving today. She is a senior. Junior from New Trier, Lisa Hoffman, she had 244.3 points in qualifying. Mackenzie Zeller, a junior from Rockford Guilford High School. Lita Swan, a senior from Elmhurst York. And diving in the number 12 position today, Bloomington High School, Monica Torres. And we should note, those are the diving order of competition as you see on your screen. That is not the current standings. We will update you on who stands where in the diving competition as the day goes on. 47 divers took place in the preliminary championships last night. They took their dives a night ago. Now they come back, as I mentioned, with three dives each to try to become the state champion for 1992.
This event's similar to the to gymnastics. It's very subjective. It's the swimming, you look at the clock, you know who the fastest swimmer is, you know who the best is. Here, it's the gymnastics type scoring. 0 to 10, it's multiplied by the degree of difficulty of the dive, and that's how we get the final point total. Actually, what they do is they cross out the high scores and the low scores. And so they're used the three best, the three middle scores for the multiplication purposes towards the degree of difficulty to get the total score.
The two young ladies from Fremd High School in Palatine are definitely the ones to look for. Kelly Telschau, who will dive first in just a moment here, the sophomore, 19th last year. She comes in qualifying in the number three spot today behind her teammate, just a freshman, Hannah Shin, and the number 23 diver, position four today, Lauren Winger, the senior from Evanston Township. Update you on the points team scoring right now if you're following along at home. New Trier High School through the 50-yard freestyle finals, leading with 56 points. If you've noticed, Bruce and I have mentioned St. Charles High School a lot today. 52 points for St. Charles right now, the defending champions from Hinsdale Central. 45 points. Deerfield in the number five position, and West Chicago with 28 points in the number five spot. Check that, Deerfield in the number four position as we speak. Interesting to note that Winnetka, New Trier, and St. Charles ahead of Hinsdale, but still there's a lot of events left in the water.
There's a lot of swimming left to go and diving. And New Trier doesn't have a medley freestyle relay later in the meet, and we'll talk about that later. Here's
Kelly Telschau, the sophomore. That's your basic forward dive from the straight position, 1.4 degree of difficulty.
And
Bruce,
she did it nice. A little bit over. And the awards are six and sevens, low score of 4.5.
Lydia, forward dive straight, 1.4. And this is Lydia Ball.
She was able to hold on to it a little bit better. Judges look here for height, their approach, and the entry in the water.
Of the three dives the young ladies will take part in, one of those, of course, is the required dive. The other two are optionals chosen by the particular diver, as you get a look at Hannah Shin for dive one.
Wow, Hannah, very nice dive. She's a lot more acrobatic, and we'll see that later in her other dives.
A lot of scores in the seven range, 1.5.0 and 1.7. Lauren Winger from Evanston Township diving fourth.
She has a little twist on her dive. And it was intentional. That was a forward dive with a one-half twist in a straight position. And her scores range from 5 to 7.
1.8 degree of difficulty on her first dive for Lauren Winger.
Laura, forward dive straight, 1.4.
The forward dive straight for Laura Coleman, 1.4 degree of difficulty. She's from Champaign Centennial High School. Early on, we see the young ladies getting the required dive out of the way early. Is there an advantage to that, Bruce?
Well, I think what they do, they're awful nervous, and they want to do a dive that they're very confident in doing, dive they've done over and over and over again. And it doesn't look like a very difficult dive, and it isn't a very difficult dive. 1.4 is the degree of difficulty. We'll see some 2.3s and 2.5s later.
Marcy Kowalski from Glenview, Glenbrook South.
She's doing just a little forward dive in the pike position. That's even a lower degree of difficulty, but she does it very well.
Just a 1.3 degree of difficulty on that dive for the junior from Glenbrook South.
Just a nice old-fashioned jackknife.
7.5s, a couple of sevens, couple of sixes, and a couple of 6.5, so the score's very even right there. Courtney Schell from Glenview, Glenbrook South.
7.5, 7, 6.
You heard the scores from Marcy right there in her first dive.
Courtney, forward dive, 1.3.
So you heard at the forward pike, 1.3 degree of difficulty for Courtney Schell.
Same as her teammate, same dive as her teammate. To me, that one looked better. She got a little bit more height, she piked beautifully, and then beautiful entry into the water. She's a junior, Courtney.
She had 260.5 points coming in. She gets a 9 on the board, a couple of 8.5s and 8.
Okay, watch the height she
six.
Gets on this dive here. She gets nice height, perfect pike, and very much in control. She's not saving it. She's not over it at all. She gets it right in there.
Great performance to start out for Courtney Schell.
Now, Kim started off with a twisting dive. It's an optional dive, a reverse 1.5 somersault with 1.5 twists.
3, 5, 2.5.
And struggled with the performance. The 5, the highest score. 3 threes, a couple of 2.5s. Kim Adelicado, but that dive was a degree of difficulty of 2.4, so the points will be added a little bit more in her favor.
Remember, the high scores, the 2 highest scores and the 2 lowest ones were knocked out. This is Lisa Hoffman from New Trier doing a forward dive, 1.3. Another pike dive.
Lisa Hoffman, the junior. Sixes, the 6.5 in there, a couple of 5.5. Her scores ranging in the 6 area. So far, the star in the first round, Courtney Schell, the junior from Glenview, Glenbrook North.
Here's Kenzie Zeller. She's doing a forward dive, 1.5 twist. This is a little higher degree of difficulty.
1.8. And well done.
Yeah, it looked like she was out a little far, but you see that a lot on some of these dives. All it takes is hitting that board once and you want to get a little farther away from the board.
She gets 3 6.5s, a 7, and 3 sixes. Watch it again.
Up she goes, looks down her arm, and actually she wasn't as far away from the board as it looked like originally.
Moving for her first dive as we were on the replay, Lita Swan, the senior from Elmhurst York High School. She came in with 250.65 points. Lita Swan with the forward dive in the pike position comes in with marks of 5 and 4.5. You get a look at the reaction of Lita right there. And the last one in this first round of dives, Monica Torres, the senior from Bloomington High School.
She did a reverse dive. Kicked out a little early, it looked like.
The reverse 1.5 somersault from the tuck position, 2.3 degree of difficulty, 5s and 4.5s, and then a 3.5 among the scores for that young lady.
She opted also to do a optional dive. She's going to do her front dive next.
The inward 1.5 somersault, tuck position, 2.2 difficulty for Kelly Telschau. Second dive.
Okay, now they get a little more difficult, the dives, and they get to be a little more interesting.
They're 5, 5, 5, 5, 5.
That moves us up to Lydia Ball. The scores were 5.5 and sixes right there. Lydia reversed 1.5 somersaults from the tuck position, 2.3 degree of difficulty from Champaign Centennial High School. Well, the crowd reaction was good.
Yeah, the crowd reaction was good.
Let's see what the judges thought. 6 her high score, a 5.5 in there, mixed with a couple of 5s, a trio of 5s, and 2 4.5s.
Watch the tuck now. She wants to try to grab those knees and then let go at the right time, and she does. She was over a little bit, and that's why we see all that splash.
Here comes Hannah Shin, a forward 1 somersault, 2 twists, 2.3 degree of difficulty.
Wow.
She's been diving since she was 7 years old, just a freshman. She was at the top of the list as we enter today's competition. Hannah Shin from Palatine Fremd High School.
You can see how she twists this beautifully. She had to win a dive off just to be here today amongst her own teammates.
6.5, her top score, had a couple of 6s intermixed in there. Here comes Lauren Winger with her second dive.
Reverse 1.5 somersault.
Lauren did not get the kick out like she wanted from Evanston Township High School. Lauren actually came in very, very strong, 273.95, but the 3.5, the top, the 3s and 2.5 there on that second dive will hurt her chances very badly right there. Laura Coleman, the senior from Champaign.
Reverse 1.5 somersault in the tuck position.
2.3 degree of difficulty.
Oh, that was a nice dive.
Kicked it out well. Came in cleanly with that dive attempt right there, number two for Laura Coleman. She gets a 5.5 from two of the judges. Check that, three of the judges. A five, a couple of 4.5s, and a four.
Now, I'm sure they'd like to see her get a little bit deeper here. You can see as she goes underwater, the judges look for that. She should try to go right for the bottom.
Marcy, a reverse 1.5 somersault from the tuck position. 2.3 degree of difficulty. Marcy Pogovsky, the junior from Glenbrook South.
Marcy did a nice job on that. She was looked controlled in the air. She didn't look like she was flailing around, and she was able to get it a little bit deeper. Her scores don't reflect that, though.
Courtney Schell, a forward 1.5 somersault with a twist from the forward position. This is her second dive.
Nice job.
Follows up a fine performance on her initial dive with a good one here on the second. It'll be interesting to see her mark. She started out with 260.5 points, 15 points behind the leader. As we watch the replay, I will check the scores for you as soon as they come up.
This is in the free position, and she twists beautifully in there, and she has it down. You can tell when she bends underneath the water there, she's trying to save it a little bit, and she feels like it's going over. But she was able to save it. It was just a technique.
Still awaiting the scores right here for Courtney Schell, who had the 8 and a 9.0 from one of the judges on her first dive, which was her basic required dive of the day. As I mentioned, she started the day at 260.5 points. Hannah Shin, 275.45, is your leader. 15 points, a lot to make up in a diving competition, Bruce?
It can be at this level. You know, at some of the lower levels where the girls aren't as consistent, then it isn't as much to make it. But at this level, when we're talking about high-quality divers, every one of them, it is a lot to make up. But she's diving very well today, and we're really seeing some good diving. You know, I think obviously the crowd favorite is Hannah from Palatine Frem, who, as I said before, is...
Well, here the scores come in. She gets 3 5.5s. A 5, a couple of 4.5s, and a 6.0. The scores for Courtney Schell, the junior from Glenbrook South on her second dive. Here's Kim Indelicato, the senior from Galesburg. Just a forward dive from the pike position. This will be her required dive. She taking her second dive to get the requirements out of the way. 1.3 degree of difficulty.
Now remember, she's the one who did the required dive, or her optional dive before. Now we're on, she has to do a required dive, and this is where she's chosen to put it in. With the concentration on Kim's face.
Kim Indelicato from Galesburg High School.
And she got sixes on that dive. She would have done that first.
As you mentioned, an opportunity to kind of get the butterflies out a little bit. Her first attempt with the 2.4 difficulty, not very successful. She comes back, performs well there. Lisa Hoffman, the junior from New Trier High School. This will be a reverse 1.5 somersault from the tuck position. Degree of difficulty, 2.3.
Lisa does well in this time.
Kicks out the legs extremely well.
Yes, I've seen her do that dive before, and she did that one very well.
And she's rewarded for it. I see a 7, 2 6.5s, a 6, 2 5.5s, and a 5.0. Lisa Hoffman from New Trier High School kicked it well at the top.
Yeah, look at that height she gets, grabs the knees, and straight into the water. Nice, very nice dive for Lisa.
Kenzie Zeller, the junior from Rockford. This will be her second dive, a reverse 1.5 somersault with a twist 2.3 degree of difficulty.
Wow, she gets some good height. You can hear her slap her knees as she grabbed them. She was off to the side a little bit, but she did.
We should mention, as we watch the replay of this dive, about the scoring again. I keep mentioning degree of difficulty. It is important to consider the scoring. There's five judges. You drop the top two and the bottom two. Check that, seven judges. The top two and the bottom two scores are out. So the three other scores stay, the middle ground, if you will. They are divided by the points, or multiplied by the points, and then multiplied by the degree of difficulty. That gives you the total points as we look at Lita right here on her second attempt. Actually, that was Kenzie Zeller on her second attempt. The reverse 1.5 somersault, 2.3 degree of difficulty from the tuck position. 3 sevens, 3 sixes, and a 6.5, and she has a big smile on her face. She is pleased with that performance.
She ought to be.
Monica Doris. That was Lita Swan, as we checked that, the inward dive with a half twist. Actually, check that. That was indeed Monica Torres, the front dive from the straight position, her required dive. One somersault, two twists, degree of difficulty 2.3. The forward dive, this is dive number three for Kelly Telshaw.
Forward, one somersault, two twists, free, 2.3.
2.3 degree of difficulty. Monica Torres was our last diver. Apologize for that slight mistake of identifying the young ladies.
Yeah, there's Kelly finished up with a beautiful dive. Two full twists on that in the free position, and she was rewarded well on that. She gets good height on the dive. You can see her twisting. One, two, back around in front, and straight in, looking straight ahead.
This is Lydia Ball, the sophomore. This will be her third dive. A back one somersault with a 1.5 twist.
Little rock on the board there. This is a very difficult dive to do. She makes it look easy.
2.3 degree of difficulty from the forward position. Gets a 6.5, but falls all the way down to 4.5 from three of the judges.
Looks back, so you grab her head to twist, and back around, and nice entry.
The front runner, Hannah Shin, her final dive.
Well, didn't quite get all the way around on that. In a reverse dive, she looked like she was running off the board. 1.5 somersaults.
And her scores are not great. 3 fours, a 3, 3.5, a 5, and a 4.5. The final dive of the day for Hannah Shin, the freshman from Fremd High School, who came in our leader. This is Lauren Winger, the senior from Evanston Township High School.
Hannah opened the door a little bit. We'll see if anybody can take advantage of that. Wow. Back 1.5 somersault, with 1.5 twist in the free position. 2.5 was the degree of difficulty. Laura, coached by Jim Bickenstaff at Evanston, she really nails this dive. Up, twist. It's hard to keep track of everything. No wonder they call that the free position. It's a little short on the entry.
Laura Coleman, her final dive, a back one somersault, 1.5 twists from the free position, 2.3 degree of difficulty.
She had her hands a little bit flatter at her side, but she did do a nice job.
4.5.
She gets 2 5.5s, 3 4.5s, and a 4.0 for the judges scoring.
I hated the judge diving. It's so difficult.
Marcy Pogowski, her final dive. She's just a junior from Glenbrook South. Kicks it up strong.
Wow, beautiful dive.
Good performance. The forward two somersault, 2.3 degree of difficulty.
Very nice job.
Very well executed by the junior, Marcy Pogowski.
Okay, watch. Now watch how Marcy gets up in the air, and she just throws for that dive. One, two, boom. Good entry.
Courtney Schell, the junior, her final dive. She performed so brilliantly in dive number one. Lands it right
nice
there.
Nice job there.
The inward 1.5 somersault from the tuck position, 2.2 degree of difficulty.
Pembroke South girls are diving well.
6.75.
She gets a 7 from one of the judges. A 6.5, a 6, two 5s, and a 5.5. A forward 2 somersault from the tuck position, 2.2 degree of difficulty. Kim and Delicato will attempt this dive. She, the senior from Galesburg, the last dive of her high school career.
Kim, forward 2 somersaults, tuck 2.2.
She reached out a little bit far on that. I don't think she wanted to be that far away from the board.
Kim and Delicato, 4.5 three times, 3.5 four times. And you can tell a little home swim advantage here. Lisa Hoffman from New Trier High School gets a good reaction prior to her third dive. A forward 1.5 somersault with a twist from the free position, 2.2 degree of difficulty.
Lisa's diving well today. Should be a good dive for as well.
Lisa Hoffman gets a good reaction from her many teammates and the parents of the New Trier swimmers here today.
Okay, watch Lisa now.
Kenzie.
Reaches, a nice twist, and head entry saves a little bit. You see her start to tuck underneath the water there, and that's what means she's trying to save that dive.
Kenzie Zeller from Rockford Guilford High School. Her third and final dive. A good performance on the forward 1.5 somersault with a twist from the free position, 2.2 degree of difficulty for Kenzie Zeller from Rockford Guilford High School.
5.5, 6, 5.
She comes in with 1.6, Bruce. 3 5.5s. Check that, 2.6s now. 3 5.5. So good marks there as we move on to Lita Swan from Elmhurst York High School.
Those Rockford girls always dive well at the state meet.
Reverse 1.5 somersault, 2.5 degree of difficulty for Lita Swan.
The pike position. Some of the fans thought she was going to hit the board. I think you could tell from the ooze in the eyes.
Let's watch closely, see if we can pick it up.
See, she is a little close to the board there, but in reality she's not. And over a little bit, as you can see how her feet slap there.
Monica Torres, the senior from Bloomington High School, to close things out here in the diving competition. Forward 1.5 somersault, 2 twists, 2.3 degree of difficulty from the free position. Monica Torres, her final dive of her high school career.
Yeah. And the final dive of this state meet.
4.5, the top score, 3.0, the bottom, 3 3.5s, and a couple of fours. The diving has completed. We'll come up, tally up some scores for you, watch the awards ceremony when we come back to New Trier High School here on Sports Channel. Welcome back to New Trier High School in Winnetka, Illinois. The diving competition is complete, and the order of finishers is also official. Kim Indelicato from Galesburg takes the number 12 spot. Monica Torres from Bloomington High School in the 11th spot. Laura Coleman finishes 10th. Lydia Ball of Champaign Centennial High School in the 9th spot. Now Lisa Hoffman finishes 8th. She gains 5 more points for New Trier High School, who leads in the team competition as we speak. Lita Swan finishes in 7th place. The top 6 come your way. Lauren Winger from Evanston Township. Kenzie Zeller from Rockford Guilford High School. Marcy Pogovsky, she had that fine second dive from Glenbrook South High School. And then South and Fremd all the way through. Kelly Telschau finishes in 3rd place. That's where she started the day. Courtney Schell, what a great dive she had to open the day, where she got 8s and 9s on the scoreboards, propels herself all the way up to the number 2 spot. but your state champion. She came in number one. She is just a freshman, Hannah Shin from Palatine Fremd High School. 370.60 points. A fine performance from Hannah Shin today, Bruce.
Yeah, Hannah did an excellent job today. Here's the second place girl.
Courtney Schell from Glenview, Glenbrook South, receiving her award from Tom Howard, who just happens to be the principal at Fremd High School, so he gets to take one of his own and congratulate her. As you see the state champion, Hannah Shin, watch for her to come back strong also in the next 3 years. A great performance today by this young lady.
Boy, she must be in shock. Just floating on air. A week ago, 2 weeks ago, didn't know whether she was going to be here. She might have thought her diving season was over. They had a dive off between the five girls at Fremd High School. She got in there. She got second by a couple points, and she ends up being the state championship. What a diving program they have at Fremd High School.
This was her second dive today, 10th overall. A strong performance, Bruce.
Yes. Really some raw talent here. You can see how she twists so well. She must be an excellent gymnast, and look at how she gets into the water. Beautiful dive, beautiful start for her diving career.
Well, as I mentioned, the diving points were accumulated coming into today, but she did not disappoint as she comes in strong on the afternoon. Hannah Shin, your winner. Which moves us now to event number six, the consolation of the 100-yard butterfly event. Lita Chidester from Woodstock High School in lane two. Corey Gilganin from West Chicago Community in lane three. Gillian Morris, the senior from Deerfield, will take lane four in the consolation. Julie Bancroft, the senior from Springfield Southeast, in five. Amanda Coe, a junior from Naperville Central High School, in lane six. And Janelle Buster, just a sophomore from Pekin High School, a 59.88 qualifying time yesterday in the preliminaries. She will take lane seven in this, our consolation of event number six, the 100-yard butterfly event.
This is an exciting event, and it will be today, too, because we have Lisa in the next heat. But this is a very grueling kind of stroke. You can tell when you watch the stroke that they'll lift both arms out of the water, pull at the same time, pull through, and the kick and breathing is very tricky in the timing. Good start there from Janelle Buster in lane seven.
Lane seven indeed from Pekin High School. The sophomore got the good jump. They are all grouped together as they reach the 25-yard spot in the first turn and into length number two.
It looks like Corey in lane three has taken an early lead in the first length.
Corey with a slight lead, and the rest of them are packed together. Still a strong performance coming from Janelle Buster as they reach the halfway point of the 100-yard butterfly.
They're that far behind.
They are all grouped together, all our swimmers, lanes two through seven, grouped very well right now as they go towards the final kick and the final length of the 100-yard butterfly event.
West Chicago Community is still ahead,
coming
lane three.
Out strong after the kick, Bruce, indeed, with a slight lead, lane five, Julie Bancroft swimming very well.
Julie's coming
five,
on nice
Julie's
and strong.
Coming on strongly with lane four, Gillian Morris. Oh. And as they touch it is lane five, Julie Bancroft. 59.25 seconds.
What a finish.
59.42, the second place finisher, Gillian Morris. A great show in the consolation heat. Julie Bancroft wins it. What a finish. This is a great way to get back into the swimming events, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a really exciting event here, and you can see what a finish it is, and it depends on where your arms are in relationship to the rest of the group there, and if the timing is so important. You want to be coming around with your hands reaching for the wall right at the finish, and that's what happened. Not caught in the middle between strokes.
Look at that, 59.25, 59.42, 59.47, and then even a 59.83. all within really 51 hundredths of a second in the finish of the consolation, which moves us to the championship. And the big story, of course, comes from Lisa Kuhl. But first, we will run down the lineup for the race. In lane two, Jillian Randall, the senior from Deerfield. Lane three, Wendy Geldler, the senior from Homewood Flossmoor. Lane four, I mentioned, Lisa Kuhl, looking for an unprecedented fourth straight title. Kate Wendt in five, Kristen Nuwaiti in six, Sarah Graves in lane seven.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
Remember, Lisa took an early lead in that 200. She went out after it. Looked like she was holding back yesterday. And that's kind of look I look to see her do the same thing today in the butterfly.
Watch for Lisa Kuhl in lane four. 56.29 she's on the boards for. Prior to this year, is the third best in history. She swam a 55.73 to qualify. The state record is 55.62.
She already has a body length lead.
She has been 2 seconds better than the rest of the field in this event, Bruce. Very close, 2, 3, and 4. She has a strong lead as she works towards her third length right here and into the final kick.
She's not swimming against the other five girls. She's swimming against the clock. She wants that record. It's something she's had her eyes on for 4 years, and here she comes. Let's watch her come in.
Held
Look
by
at that
Kristen
crowd.
Stout.
Watch the crowd. Grueling.
They love it right now. She is at the 50-second mark right now as she pushes it hard. Lisa Kuhl will be the state champion. Will she hold a state record?
Yes, yes, yes!
54.99, Lisa Kuhl.
Wow.
Rockford Guilford High School, her fourth straight title in the 100-yard butterfly event.
And there's a tie for fourth again. There's another tie. But look at this crowd. Everybody on their feet. Lisa Kuhl.
What an amazing performance. 54.99. She bets the state record by over a half a second. She came in, kicked hard off the last turn, and as you mentioned, the only competition she had was from 1987-88, the record held by Kristen Stout.
Yeah, okay, watch her finish here. Look at the turnover she has. Some people can like to turn over that fast in the freestyle, but here she has a nice turnover, leg kick, and finishes in. Nice job, and boy, is she happy. That was a goal.
Lisa Kuhl with the state record, with her fourth state championship, her second state championship of the day. We'll take a break. Watch her get yet another award. Come back with the 100-yard freestyle event. That is all, plus more coming up next. The broadcast rights to today's swimming and diving finals have been granted to Sports Channel by the Illinois High School Association solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any reproduction of this event without the written consent of Sports Channel and the IHSA is prohibited. Mike Goldberg, Bruce Woodbury back at New Trier High School. Event number 6, the 100-yard butterfly. 12th place goes to Amanda Coe from Naperville Central High School. Leader Chai Dester from Woodstock comes in the 11th spot. Janelle Buster from Pekin in a 10th spot. Corey Gilgallen from West Chicago Community. Then Gillian Morris from Deerfield. And winning the consolation heat was Julie Bancroft of Springfield Southeast High School. Your top 6, Jillian Randall. A tie between Kristen Nawida from Winnetka, New Trier, and Sarah Graves for the number 4 spot. So they get 10.5 points each, Bruce. Kristen, a good performance. New Trier did have a swimmer in this event. Hinsdale Central did not. Interesting to note as we go on through the team scoring, the rest of the individuals, Wendy Geldler from Homewood Flossmoor, Oak Park River Forest, Kate Wendt, and Lisa Kuhl. 3 seconds better than the competition today, setting a state record with her fourth straight win in the 100-yard butterfly event. What a show today as you get a look at the number 2 finisher right there. A good number 2 for Kate Wendt of Oak Park River Forest, 57.97. But a state record and a standing ovation from the crowd here at New Trier High School.
Look at the back of her shirt, 4-time state champ, 100 fly.
And indeed she did. She adds that to her win in the 200 freestyle. She goes out in style. 54.99 seconds, a new state record for Lisa Kuhl from Rockford Guilford High School.
And this crowd very appreciative of what she's done for swimming, and especially in this event in the last 4 years. Lisa, nice job.
And when you win it 4 times, you deserve to have your name in the record books, not only for winning it 4 times, but for holding the state record. She beats the state record by over 1.5 seconds, so a fine performance indeed for Lisa Kuhl. Event number 7, the consolation of the 100-yard freestyle event. Katie Polizak from LaGrange Lions High School, just a sophomore in lane 2. Terry Wagoner from Naperville Central High School in lane 3. Sarah Adams, a freshman from Washington, she will take lane 4 as the fastest qualifier in the consolation heat right now. Joy Gallagher from Midlothian, Heather Potkin, a sophomore from Dunlap, we mentioned her name a little bit earlier in the relays, and Chrissy Jansen, just a freshman from Lake Forest High School, 54.44 seconds. You look down these consolation heats, Bruce, you see the freshmen and the sophomores, we see the future of the swimming competition.
Take your mark.
It's really important to break in here at this level, any place. Sometimes just qualifying, but if you can get get in here and be in some of the consolations, that really is going to hold the experience is so important for next year.
Absolutely. You understand what this afternoon means. You understand the procedure. You learn about your waiting and coming through and understanding the whole procedure of winning a state championship. As they come to the 50-yard mark, dead even, all five swimmers touch and kick off the wall again, taking a slight lead, it looks like, in lane five is Joy Gallagher from Midlothian Bremen High School.
And interestingly enough, she's the only senior in the field.
She would like to take the seventh place spot if she can. She got a good kick off the wall, has a slight lead over Sarah Adams, the freshman in lane four. Still holding just a slight lead. A battle's going to be close for third place. It looks like Joy Gallagher will get the touch, and she does. 53.32 seconds. Second place goes to Sarah Adams, the freshman in lane four. Third place goes to lane two, Katie Polisak, the sophomore from LaGrange Lions. And we have another tie for fourth place between Heather Potkin of Dunlap and Chrissy Jansen, the freshman at Lake Forest, 53.95 seconds.
It's uncanny the number of ties we've had today to the hundredth of a second. It's a good thing, as you said before, that we have that automatic timing.
So you mentioned it, the senior, Joy Gallagher, goes out in style. She wins the consolation heat here of the 100 freestyle event. Watch the strong finish here. Indeed, this one is a sprint, 100-yard freestyle. She gets the good kick off the back wall, comes back down the last 25 yards in style.
Look at the finish now. In the bottom of the screen there, black cap, nice finish, hard leg kick in, and she finishes. The senior wins. It's a great way to finish your swimming career. Boy, here's going to be a race.
100-yard freestyle championship. No one from New Trier. Two young ladies from Hinsdale Central among the field right now as we get ready for the gun.
This will help Hinsdale Central in that team race.
Take your mark.
Meredith Quas from Hinsdale Central in lane two. Marnie Record, the senior, Springfield High School, lane three. J.J. Bontranger, the senior from Naperville North, a fine performer. She is in lane four. Jennifer Steffen, the junior from Hinsdale Central, in lane five. Kim Laughlin from Chicago Lane, the first public league young lady in the history of swimming to qualify for this event, 100 yards. And Claudine Chowo from Park Ridge, Maine.
J.J.'s got the early lead.
Seven. J.J. But, moving it up.
Jennifer Steffen from Hinsdale has got out there to get her. Hinsdale really needs this. And Meredith Quast in lane two is up there as well. Hinsdale has a real opportunity to gain in that team totals. They're about 25 and a half points down, and they could use a good shot in the arm here if they're going to challenge for that team trophy.
J.J. Bontranger looks like she will touch first. And she does. In lane four, no surprise, Naperville North, J.J. Bontranger, the senior, the top qualifier in the 50. She comes in strong with a championship here in the 100-yard freestyle. Lane two does go to Hinsdale Central. The second place finish, Jennifer Steffen, the junior, Hinsdale Central. And they also capture third place,
okay,
Hinsdale
Central's
Meredith Quast.
J.J. here at the in the middle of the screen in the orange cap, and right next to her is the Hinsdale Central swimmer, Jennifer Steffen, and at the very top of the screen is the other Hinsdale swimmer, Meredith Quack. And nice finish again for J.J. Again, all girls finish with their arms straight ahead and kicking into the wall.
J.J. does it with style. She gets yet another state championship. We'll come back, watch her receive her awards. Move on to the next event, the 500-yard freestyle. That's coming up next. The site, New Trier High School, Winnetka, Illinois, the 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships. Event number seven, the 100-yard freestyle. Terry Wagoner from Naperville Central. Heather Potkin and Chrissy Jansen tie for 10th place. Katie Polisak from LaGrange Lions comes in number nine. Sarah Adams from Washington in the eighth spot. And the winner of the consolation heat was Joy Gallagher from Midlothian. Top six. Claudine from Park Ridge, Maine East comes in six. Marnie Record from Springfield High School in five. Kim Laughlin, Chicago Lane. A great performance for Kim, the first public leaguer to take part in this event. And then Hinsdale Central, Bruce, does exactly what they need to. They take the number three and number two spots in Quast and Jennifer Steffen. But J.J. Bontranger adds to her 50-yard victory, the 100-yard freestyle. She wins the state championship today, JJ from Naperville North High School, 51.61 seconds, her winning time.
She looks exhausted there. And as you say, Hinsdale did exactly what they wanted to do. The score going into that event was 71.5 for New Trier and 45 for Hinsdale, coming out of that event at 71.5, 70.
With the 2-3 finishes, they gain 25 points as we move on to event 8, the consolation of the 500-yard freestyle, the marathon event in swimming and diving. Gillian Morris in lane 2 of the consolation heat. Beth Updegraff from Homewood Flossmore in lane 2 and in lane 3. Heidi Rodschke from Beacon High School, just a freshman, she is in lane 4. Lane 5, Stacy Seiler from Westmont, just a sophomore. Nicole Redmond from Oak Park River Forest in 6, she is a senior. And Molly Sullivan, a junior from Peoria Richwoods High School. 5 minutes 12 seconds, .04 yesterday, her qualifying time in the prelims. As they go into the marathon of them all, the 500-yard freestyle event.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
This event used to be a distance event. Now, we kind of call this a middle distance event. The girls swim so fast now, they really don't have too much time for resting them during the event. There's a little bit of strategy. You have to plan your strength. Some girls are can go out a little bit harder. Others want to try to keep a steady pace. We look a lot for what we call negative splitting here, where you swim evenly the whole way. You go out in 2 minutes and 30 seconds, and you come back in 2 minutes and 30 seconds. This should be quite an exciting race.
They make the kick 500 yards in all. I'll tell you what, that shows the endurance of these young ladies. And you talked about how it has turned into a little bit less of an endurance race, a little bit of a middle sprint. It can't be a sprint, obviously, but I think that's a credit to how far these young ladies have come athletically, really, in the past decade.
And the training has improved so much over the last couple of years. It takes a special kind of person, though, to be able to train for this kind of event. It's not easy. It takes 3, 4, 5 hours a day, 5 and 6 days a week, not to mention the weight training. A lot of demand on the time for these young ladies.
And it's a key you say weight training, because a decade ago, maybe even when you were winning all your state championships, Bruce, that wasn't as much a part of the regime, was it?
It wasn't as much, and we were doing weight training at that time, but not every school was, and that was one of the things I think that kept us apart. In fact, the person that developed our weight training program, Tony Harper, is the current coach at New Trier.
Beth Updegraff has a lead at this point in our race, Homewood Flossmore High School. She qualified with a time of 5 minutes, 10 seconds, 0.16. As they kick it back up, another 25-yard length, and they just go on and on and on in this one, don't they?
They're a special breed, distance swimmers and middle-distance swimmers. They like to tease the sprinters. When the going gets tough, the old saying goes, the sprinters get out. And these girls train and train and train.
You get a good look at Beth right there, your leader right now, as they kick it through the ninth turn.
I think they have those counters down there for the fans. The girls know exactly where they are. They know exactly. They swim the races by hundreds. The fans get lost a little bit sometimes. The fans aren't as smart as the swimmers. The girls know exactly where they are.
You break it down into 5 100s. Which is up and back twice each. You know, there is big math. You might need a calculator for this event, right, if you're at home, right?
At these girls.
The 11th turn right now as they work at about a 250, 251 into this race. The state record is 4 minutes and 48 seconds. We may see a challenger towards that in the finals, but it's highly unlikely. The top time in the finals was Ann Campy, of all people, the defending champion at 455.81. So greatly off the pace set by Bridget Bowman. We'll talk more about that, though, when we get to
Beth
the final
race. Beth is just steadily pulling away from Homewood Flossmore here, and she's just turning and turning and turning. It looks like she's got a nice pace going. Some of the girls now are starting to catch up a little bit. In particular, Gillian Morris over there in lane 2, it is.
When you talk about Gillian Morris in lane 2, she's from Deerfield High School. Not a great gap in these swimmers. but indeed a lead going in lane three for Beth Updegraff, the senior from Flossmoor. The freshman, Heidi Rajke from Beacon High School, hanging in there tough. In second place still is Gillian Morris, the senior in lane two, top of your screen from Deerfield High School.
And Gillian just got out of the water. She was swimming in the butterfly. Remember, she was in the consolation heat of our in the butterfly, and now she's back again.
We're at the 4 minute mark of the race. These young ladies winding it down.
Still, it's about 2 seconds. And she started to close it a little bit, and now she's starting, Gillian looks like she's backing off slightly. There's only 100 yards to go.
100 yards remaining in the race as the girls kick it back and forth, making a strong turn and pinching the field. Beth Updegraff, the senior, has really pushed herself out a nice lead right now. In lane two, though, still giving chase is Gillian Morris.
This is the gun lap.
You hear the gun for the final lap, as Bruce mentioned, and a strong kick off the wall by Updegraff, and she really upped her lead with that kick off the wall.
She did up her lead, and you can tell that she looks like she's getting stronger. Look at her turnover now. It's a lot faster than it was before. She's into the sprint mode. She knows she only has a lap to go, and you know these girls know that they can take any amount of pain for 26 seconds, whatever it takes to go that last.
She's really kicking it hard right now. Kicking it hard in lane three. The finish for second and third place will be interesting, though. Lane five, Stacy Seiler made a nice move at the end, and she comes in second place. But the championship of the consolation heat goes to Beth Updegraff. 5 minutes, 7 seconds, 0.46, 509, 0.05 in lane five for Stacy Seiler. The sophomore from Westmount came on strong very late in the race. Lane four, just a freshman, Heidi Rajke, with the time of 509.95, gets third place in the consolation heat.
Okay, you can see how her turnover, well, it's hard to tell in that slow motion, but it's going normal speed, and you can tell the turnover is really hard and really fast, and she's into that sprint mode that she kicks a little bit harder and goes back to her six-speed kick and finishes nice and strong. Wow, nice swim for her.
Beth Updegraff, the senior from Homewood Flossmoor High School, a fine performance in this, our consolation heat, which moves us, of course, to the freestyle championship. The state record, as I mentioned, 4 minutes, 48 seconds. Bridget Bowman of Glenbard West in 86 and 87. She already lost one record today, though, the 200-yard IM to none other than Ann Campy. Lindy Mercy, though, starts Mercer from Normal Community High School, is in lane two. Kim Vender from New Trier High School, the only New Trier swimmer in this event, none from Hinsdale Central. There's Campy, the fine performer, already has won a state championship earlier today. Kim DeCroy, the senior from Peoria Richwoods High School, takes over in lane five. Lane six is Jamie White, the senior from Wheaton North. And in lane seven, Courtney Coleman, a sophomore from Warrenville High School in Wheaton.
This ought to be quite a race here. Ann Campy is close to that state record, but not far behind is Kim DeCroy. And this should be a real good race.
4.55.81, Ann Campy's qualifying time. She is the defending champion in this event. Kim DeCroy's qualifying time was 4.56.57. Interesting to note, though, last year Kim DeCroy swam a 5.04.63, so in a year she takes seconds off. Doesn't sound like a lot if we're just walking out to the car to go to the grocery store, but in swimming, that is an eternity.
That's a lot of time that she's improved over the last year, and I'm sure she's worked really hard to make those improvements. These girls that are seniors now are swimming for scholarships too. Their swimming is going to help them get them into college, and it'll also help maybe pay for their college.
Ann Campy won the 200-yard individual medley, setting a state record, 203.56. She's going after another one of Bridget Bowman's state records right here. Ann Campy, the defending champion. Hard to tell at this early stage, as the girls are just into their pace right now, and I'd like to see the end of the race, see if Ann Campy or Kim DeCroy can really put a great kick in like Beth Updegraff did. She did exactly like you mentioned, Bruce. She got stronger as the race went on.
She did get stronger, and you can see that Ann looks real strong right now. She's a very strong and confident swimmer right now after her swim earlier in the day. comes off the wall strong. She's kicking hard, breathing. She knows exactly where she is. I'm sure her coach has signaled her somehow just that she's okay and she's right on the pace she wants to be. They train to do the pace work. She's out in 154 with a place in the consolation final.
Is there ever a situation where the young lady may be at too strong of a pace and the coach can actually give her a, can you get a signal to your swimmer that you got to back it off a little bit?
I think at this level, it's kind of hard. It's hard to see, especially in a crowd like this, it's hard to pick out your coach. You're focused in and you're trained. You know exactly where you should be and you know what it feels like to be at that pace. These girls know exactly how they swam so many 500s that they can't even see straight right now. But Anne looks like, look at how she's getting stronger and stronger. She's concentrating. She knows that she should pick it up in the third 100, and that's what she's done. This is probably one of the 100s that she's worked on. There's never a problem going the first 50 or the first 100 in these races. The adrenaline's going. You're so excited. It's when the adrenaline wears off a little bit. The third 100 and the fourth 100, those are the ones you have to focus in on. And that's what Ann looks like she's doing here now.
She's certainly building herself up a lead over lane 5 and Kim DeCroix. It is a 1-2 between Ann and Kim right now. Ann has a strong lead in third place. Really, we've got all four swimmers kind of tied for the third place position as Ann seems to be continuing to go strong at her pace. So does Kim. It's just a little bit behind the defending state champion right now.
You've got to be an added incentive, too, trying to win that state championship for the third time.
Yeah, she really is kicking a lead now. But a strong kick again. Kim DeCroix seems like she falls back, but she's playing very, very well off the wall. She's getting some strong leg kicks, Bruce.
Yeah, she is. But, you know, one of the things you don't want to do is lose contact with your opponent. There's a little drag effect if you can be right there on their legs. And you don't see, I think Kim's letting her get away a little bit more than she wanted to do.
And can't be.
Of course, there's another side to that. Ann wanted her to pull away from her a little bit so she couldn't drag off of her.
She touched the last split at 3.5, 3.44 in the two position. 5 seconds back is Kim DeCroix. So, indeed, Ann has built herself up a nice lead. 3.53.44 at the last split.
She only has to go another 100, and she's already on a very good pace to improve her time from last night. She needs to go a minute for this last 100, and then she will... She'll be the next state champion.
Again, the defending state champion to do it again, take her second title of the day. We see the cream rise to the top. She won the 200 IM, looks safely in the lead here in the 500-yard freestyle event. Still in second place is Kim DeCroix. As she kicks it for the final 25, Ann Campy, the senior from Decatur MacArthur High School. We're at the 4:45 mark right now. She will not get a state record. But she will get
pace.
A state championship.
She was on a beautiful pace, 30 seconds per 50, and exactly another 20. That was a 29.8 for the last 50. Very evenly swum race, beautifully swum, nice strategy. She knew exactly where she was and did a fine job.
Improved on a fine time of a night ago, a 4:55.81, and Campy defends her championship in the 500-yard freestyle event as she congratulates Kim DeCroix. 4:53.21, your winning time. Just under 3 seconds better than the second place finisher in lane 5, Kim DeCroix. Jamie White in lane 6 takes third place.
And here's the last 50, and actually the last 25 of her race. She's got the same kind, she stepped it up a little bit again. She's into that sprint mode a little bit, but she's almost was in the sprint mode the whole way. She has kept that even pace the whole way. That's exactly the way her coach wanted to swim it, and she did a nice job.
And
nice
Campy, her second state title of the day. Bruce, a fine performance from the senior. She goes out in style. We go to break, come back with the awards in the 200-yard freestyle relay. Great exchanges. A great performance by Ann Campy. She defends her championship in the 500-yard freestyle event. 4 minutes 53.21 seconds. Good enough for a first-place finish and almost a 3-second advantage over Kim DeCroix. Ann Campy, a fine meet today. She wins the 200-yard individual medley, setting a state record.
and smiles again for the 500-yard freestyle event for Ann Camphy. Now, it's interesting to look at the standings at this point in our competition. New Trier leading Hinsdale Central by 10 points. The battle for 1-2, the Red Devils of Hinsdale Central, the two-time defending champions. They have six swimmers today, three relay teams. New Trier, seven swimmers, two relays. The difference? The relay teams in the relay points that can be gained right now in the 200-yard freestyle relay event. Hinsdale Central, we'll see them in the finals in a moment. They set a state record last night in qualifying. This could be the turning point right here, the big 32 points that could push the title back into Hinsdale Central's advantage, Bruce.
It's been exciting so far, and we've seen a lot of good swimming from everybody. New Trier swam exceptionally well. They've had a great meet up to this point. You can't do anything, though, if you don't have any swimmers in the water, and that's what they're facing right now.
You look at the consolation heat for this event. Midlothian in lane two, Homewood Flossmore, the young ladies from that Fine High School in lane three, Oak Park River Forest in the consolation, lane four with the fastest qualifying time. LaGrange Lions will start in lane five, Naperville North in six, and Rockford Guilford High School in lane seven of our competition. The 200-yard freestyle relay, 25 yards, 50 yards a girl, up and back. They move it quickly, and when you talk about this event, you talk about the adrenaline that gets pumping if you're the number two, number three, or number four swimmer.
Well, it's pumping for everybody. Remember when we talked about in the 50-yard freestyle, it was a start, a turn, and a finish. Well, we've got that times four now, and there's an added dimension, the relay start. The girls can start moving before the actual swimmer touches the wall. Their feet have to be on the block, though, when that girl touches the wall. That's a real critical factor in this race. It can really help you if you can have those great relay starts.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
They're off. This one will not last long, Bruce. 37 seconds, the state record. Look for the winner to be in the 40-second range here in our consolation meet.
1 minute and 40 seconds, and Nicole Redmond from Oak Park River Forest looks like she's out pretty strong, but look over here in the outside lane. Outside smoke in lane seven, Midlothian.
Rockford, Guilford, and on the near side, they get the first exchange and a good one for Midlothian. Christy Gallagher hitting the water first. The second swimmer of the four for these girls, as Bruce mentioned, watch for it in the 1 minute 40 second range of this race, 1:37, the state record.
23.73 from Roberta Bazak from Midlothian. What a start. That would have placed her in the top in the 50.
Yeah, that's when you start talking about that, and she didn't get the moving start. She had to start from the regular position just like she would have if it was the 50.
Absolutely, and they still got the lead now.
In lane seven, Rockford Guilford, 141.20 yesterday, the 12th qualifier of them all. Right now they lead in the consolation heat, but closing quickly in lane three is Homewood Flossmore under Christine Tripp. They hit the water for the third 50 yards. And the pack really starting to get tight right now. Guilford has lost a little bit. Homewood Flossmore and Oak Park River Forest has picked up speed. Flossmore in lane three with a slight lead, but the pack is tightening greatly as we work it to the last part.
There's the finish, and it is Flossmore that finishes first.
A good one indeed, 139.99. We said it would be around a minute 40. Indeed, we were very close. 139.99 in lane three for Homewood Flossmore High School. They win the consolation. Oak Park River Forest takes second place, 140.35, and a tie again for third place between LaGrange and Naperville North.
Okay, here it looks like the finish here in lane three with Flossmore. Getting stronger and stronger, and the field is gaining on her, but she's able to hold on at the end and finishes strong and hard. Down at the bottom, J.J. Bottinger got the lead for Rockford Guilford. They just weren't able to hang on.
And who had the last leg for Homewood Flossmore? None other than Beth Uptegraff, a fine swim right there. The championship of the 200-yard freestyle relay. In lane two, Lake Forest High School. In lane three, the young ladies from Deerfield. Lane four, a state record set last night, 137.07. Hinsdale Central, Schaumburg in five. The defending champions from West Chicago Community in six, and Aurora Rosary in lane seven.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
Good start in the far lanes, two and three, Lake Forest and Deerfield.
This is exciting. Meredith Quest for Hinsdale is out in front, just slightly. Little trouble coming off the wall, but she straightened herself out quickly.
Hinsdale Central in lane four.
Watch those red caps.
Gets the first touch and a good kick. Second swimmer is Krista Coranda. And Krista motoring through the first 25 yards of her two lanes.
A whole body length lead. Remember, this is the team that set the state record last night.
And a strong kick indeed. She has a slight lead over the team from Deerfield. Swimming for Deerfield is Black in the second position. Strong in lane two, also Lake Forest High School. Off in the red caps again, Hinsdale Central. The third 50 yards.
All Hinsdale has to do is win it and not get disqualified, because they need those 32 points to make a lead on New Trier.
And if Nellie Roberts gets Jennifer Steffen in a position where she's the front runner in this final leg, you can forget about it, because Steffen, a fine performer, will try to win it for Hinsdale Central.
Watch the start. Good safe start.
She's off first and off with a good lead right now in lane number four.
Lake Forest is coming on strong too. Mary Kay Honnick.
In lane two, lane three is Deerfield. The kick in the turn for the last 25 for Hinsdale Central's Jennifer Steffen.
All we have to do now is watch that clock.
132 it stands at right now as Jennifer kicks it hard in. And the 32 points for the relay championship are going to belong to the Hinsdale Central Red Devils. A good finish, second and third. 24. 1/100th of a second separate number two from number three. Central does what the doctor orders. They win the 200-yard freestyle relay.
Hey, watch the relay exchange here. Jennifer had to be safe. She knew that, but she had a great start. You could tell she was moving a little bit, and that's fine. That's perfectly legal. She's out in front. She puts her head down now, and all she has to do is swim hard, swim for the time, swim for the trophy, swim for the team, and maybe the state championship for the team.
A big 32 points gained there by Hinsdale Central with the relay championships. The points in the relays doubled, as you well know, at this point in the telecast. Hinsdale Central not
watch
very
finish
far
now.
Off,
great.
Bruce. The 137.07 of last night, they come in with a time of 137.21 in this race, so another fine performance by those young ladies. But they will get their awards coming up. We'll take a break right now. Work it to the 100-yard backstroke. That's coming up next. We are back at New Trier High School, Winnetka, Illinois, working towards the downward swims of today's meet, and indeed it has been a good one so far. Midlothian comes in 12th place of the 200-yard freestyle relay, finishing in the bottom spot of the consolation. Rockford Guilford High School in 11, another tie. Naperville North, LaGrange Lions, 9th place overall. Oak Park River Forest in the 8th spot and winning the consolation heat. Flossmoor, Homewood Flossmoor High School with a fine performance in their heat. In the finals, 6 through 1, Schaumburg comes in the 6th spot. Aurora Rosary, number 5. Lake Forest was disqualified. Deerfield comes in number 3. West Chicago Community comes in the number 2 spot. They were the defending champions in this event. Hinsdale Central, as was ordered, 137.21, just 1/14 of a second off their state record pace of a night ago. Hinsdale Central doing the job in the 200-yard freestyle relay.
So because of that quiz qualification, Aurora moves up to 4th and Schaumburg moves up to 5th. And there's no points awarded for 6th in that event.
And that hurts Lake Forest's overall team performance. Obviously, they had a great chance to gain some points in a relay event where the points are double but could not take advantage of it.
That's the second relay for Lake Forest that's been disqualified. They had one in the prelims last night that was disqualified. And they've got a young team and they're learning, but I guarantee you they'll be back. They've built a beautiful new facility up there. They're going to be anxious to get back and prove that they have a bona fide contending team next year.
Get a look at some of the young ladies receiving the medals, things they will hold on forever. But this, as we talked about before the race, the turning point in today's matchup. Hinsdale Central with the victory in the relay games, 32 points. They now have over a 20-point lead on Nutrier High School, who comes in at second place at 80.5 points after having the tie earlier today. Deerfield in the number three spot, West Chicago and St. Charles. A good battle right there for 4 and 5. The team standings after 9 events of our competition this afternoon.
Well, St. Charles ought to be able to make a move in the backstroke coming up here. They've got Gretchen Verdorn, and she ought to be able to help them out.
There you see the teams getting the awards. The Hinsdale Central Red Devils working their way towards the award ceremony. A great performance by these young ladies, not only tonight, but last night with the state record, 1:37.07. The Hinsdale Central Red Devil young ladies, when you talk about state champions, you talk about depth, and that brings us to relay events.
Depth and team scoring. The state meet has become a sprint and freestyle meet. If you don't have enough freestylers now that they've added this new relay, you're gonna be in big time trouble. And Hinsdale has always had freestylers, and that's their specialty. They've had distance freestylers, specialty freestylers, and they've traditionally been strong in the back of the butterfly too.
When we entered the diving event number 5, it looked like Nutrier had made some gains in points, and that was exactly true. They did so, but the Red Devils in these events 6 through 12 really have the strength of their lineup. We'll talk about the young ladies who will take part in the 100-yard backstroke finals in a minute, two of them from Central. First of all, though, we have the consolation heat of the 100-yard backstroke event, event number 10 of the afternoon. And they'll set it up like this. Lynn Hernandez from Trinity High School, just a sophomore. River Forest, Trinity High School, Lynn Hernandez in 2. Corey Gilgallon, the senior from West Chicago Community, yet in another event today. Chris Mackey, the senior from Naperville Central, the fastest qualifying time among the consolation participants. Laura Hoffman, a junior from Lake Forest High School. Jenny Swarson, a senior from Nutrier. She's the only Nutrier swimmer in this event, consolation or finals bracket. And then Allison Kosobowski, a junior from Crystal Lake Central High School, 59.94 seconds yesterday, the 100-yard backstroke event. The number 10 stop on our rounds of swimming and diving today from Nutrier High School.
This ought to be quite an event. Jenny Swarson, as you said, in lane 6, the only Nutrier swimmer. She's had quite a career at Nutrier, and she's going to finish it up here in the bench.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
They need a good performance from her. Obviously, as we mentioned before, you can't move into the top spots, even if your time is greater than some of those in the finals. But a seventh place would certainly bring forth 14 points for Nutrier. They need every point they can hop onto right now.
Boy, it's dead even, too. It's hard to tell who's ahead from this angle. Even from our camera angle right at the side, it's difficult to tell. But they're all moving pretty well through the water. You need a nice, strong leg kick, good concentration for the turns to get off the wall. Jenny spends a little more time underwater than most, and a new technique for most of these swimmers.
In lane 2, Lynn Hernandez kicked the first wall first, but still, as you mentioned, Bruce, they are all gathered together as we come into the last 25. Kicking diligently at the top of your screen, lane 2, Lynn Hernandez, the sophomore, pushing on tightly. Allison Kosobowski, the junior.
It looks like Lynn at the top is going to finish.
Lynn at the top indeed. River Forest, Trinity High School.
Almost a full second faster than she did last night for Lynn Hernandez from River Forest, at Trinity, and you can tell she is happy.
As a matter of fact, as you look at the board, you'll see it interesting. From 2 through 7, we almost went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just a switch in lane 6 and 7. Jenny Swarson finishing in 6th place, 1:00.21, but your winner, Lynn Hernandez, almost a second better than the second competitor, Corey Gilgallon.
You can see Lynn at the very top of your screen there as the camera pans out. She's moving her hands, there she is, moving her hands really quickly, arms quickly, and she reaches and stretches for the wall. She can eye those pennants at the top of the screen there that tell the backstrokers they still have 5 more yards to go.
59 flat for Lynn Hernandez. We move it to the championship, the 100-yard backstroke. The state record, 56.65, set yesterday.
In lane two, Janie Reed from Champaign Central, just a sophomore. Colleen Smith among those vying for the title in 90-91 and again here in 92 from Hinsdale Central. A state record last night set by this young lady, Gretchen Verdorn, the senior from St. Charles High School.
Her goal is to go 55 seconds.
Kate Wendt, the senior from Oak Park River Forest. She is in lane five. Jennifer Roberts is the junior in lane six from Hinsdale Central. A 58.29 in the prelims. And Aaron Diddy from Decatur, Stephen Decatur High School. A fine performance last night, 58.88. And as you mentioned, Gretchen looking for that 55 mark today, Bruce. The 56.65, she said afterwards, was bad. How can a state record be bad?
Her goal is 55 seconds. That's what she wants to do. And I'm going to...
We will see if she can do so as we get ready for the start of the 100-yard backstroke finals.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
She gets a good start in lane four. That's the one to watch, Gretchen Verdorn. And then Hinsdale Central again with two young ladies in this event. New chair, none in the finals. Lanes three and six belong to the Lady Red Devils of Hinsdale Central.
Boy, Gretchen is out beautifully. What a stroke. What a backstroker.
You'll notice she does not have the cap on. She shaved her head for inspiration or something, but it's working right now as she's trying to win the championship outright. She shared the title a year ago with lane five's Kate Wendt from Oak Park River Forest. Right now she has a strong lead as she completes the third length, and she'll kick it for the last 25.
And there's another state record holder in there as well, champion Colleen Smith, held it 2 years ago. She won the backstroke.
Gretchen, 54, will touch first. She'll get a 56.79, which is a little behind her pace yesterday, the 56.65. She has to be pleased because once again, Gretchen Verdorn is the state champion in the 100-yard backstroke.
I'm sure she's just a little bit disappointed because I know she wanted that 55. It's been a long 2 days, though, and you don't know the toll it takes on kids and coaches and parents until you've been through this experience. It's quite an experience to go through.
Gretchen caps it off, the senior, with the championship and the 100-yard backstroke. She will receive her awards, and we'll move it on to the 100-yard breaststroke. That's all coming up next. Back at the 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships, Mike Goldberg, along with former New Trier High School head coach Bruce Woodbury, Jenny Swarson from New Trier High School, takes the number 12 position. Allison Kosabowski from Crystal Lake in the 11th spot, Laura Hoffman from Lake Forest, number 10, Chris Mackey, Corey Gill-Gallon from West Chicago Community, and Lynn Hernandez winning the consolation heat. She is from Trinity High School. And in the top six, Janie Reed from Champaign Central, Colleen Smith and Jennifer Roberts, 5-4. Hinsdale Central Red Devils get 21 more points for the team standings. Aaron Diddy, 1/100th of a second slower than Kate Wendt of Oak Park River Forest, who was a tie for the defending championship with Gretchen Verdorn. She didn't get her 55, Bruce. Instead, she got a 56.79, but she defends her state championship.
She has nothing to be ashamed of. She's a classy champion and has had an outstanding meet today. I think she's swimming the free relay at the end of the meet, too. So she's got one more event.
She wins the state championship from St. Charles High School. A fine performance for that young lady. Two events remaining. This is the second to last. Event number 11, the consolation race of the 100-yard breaststroke. Deidre Geisler from Palatine High School in lane two. Karen Rancourt from Libertyville in lane three. Sarah Stevens in lane four from Urbana High School. St. Charles freshman Amy Munns in lane five. Anne-Marie Perry from Elk Grove Village in six. And Pram Rakansky from Lake Forest High School in lane seven. The freshman Munns in the number five lane, one to watch for in this race.
Sarah Stevens is quite an athlete. This is her eighth state meet. Three in cross country, two in swimming, and two in track.
Sarah from Urbana High School, Bruce, is in lane four, the fastest qualifier for this, our consolation meet. She had a 107.29 yesterday.
And she just missed getting into the finals. I think it's 1/100th of a second.
107.29. 107.22. Misty Lorich, 107.28 were the top two spots, the last qualifiers for the final. So you're exactly right on that. What a heartbreaker for this young lady. Now she will just try to get it, the number seven spot, do the best she can and win her consolation.
That's right. And she's off to a good start. This breaststroke is a funny event. It's hard to tell what the strengths of each of the girls are. Some are really strong leg kickers, some are strong with their arms. And that's what it looks like we've got here with Sarah. She looks like she has a little bit stronger arms and leg kick. She really can stretch out and get a good hold of the water and pull back.
They are all bunched together tightly as we close it down. What a finish we may have. Maybe one of the closest of the afternoon. Sarah Stevens seems to have a slight edge, the junior from Urbana that you mentioned.
And she's the leader, 107.
107.30. Sarah Stevens in lane four, 0.61 better than lane five's Amy Munns, the freshman from St. Charles High School. And in lane six, Anne-Marie Perry, the sophomore from Elk Grove Village, in third place, 108.08.
Sarah's just 1/100th of a second off what she was last night. Now look at her arms. She comes up out of the water and she recovers the arms instead of under the water. She recovers the arms over the water. It's like a butterfly almost that comes underneath your chest. See how their arms come up above the water? A little less resistance less that way, a little less tiring, and she can keep her stroke nice and narrow.
Sarah Stevens, who missed this race right here, the championship, by 1/100th of a second. The state record is 103.84. Sue Johnson of Naperville North, 1984-85. In lane two from Aurora Rosary, Misty Lorich. In lane three, two straight years, but the number three qualifier, two state championships for Jenny Grable. Ellen Frauman in lane four from Deerfield. Lane five is teammate Christian of Jenny Grable. Lane six, Brittany Klein, a sophomore. Lane seven, Kate McMillan, a freshman.
Take your mark.
From Grove.
Stand up.
Boy, as if there isn't enough tension in this race to have the starter ask him to stand up. He must have thought somebody's moving just slightly. You've got to have it absolutely quiet.
Mr. Starter, take your mark.
Excellent start by the girls. That's something I know Jenny's worked on, Jenny Grable in lane three.
Jenny Grable in lane three has won this event the last 2 years. As a freshman, 1 minute 5.54 seconds. She bettered that in 1990, 105.42, 105.91, her qualifying. Frauman and New Whitey in 4 and 5 expected to give the big challenges, and right now it is those three young ladies, Grable, Frauman, and New Whitey, the two young
Grable.
Ladies from New Trier. Grable touches first.
Boy, they're all out faster than they were last night, almost by half a second. So you can tell that they're really concentrating on this race, in particular the first 50.
The split at 30.23 for Jenny Grable as they kick it into the last 25. Jenny Grable in lane three from New Trier High School, looking for her third straight title in this event. Closing in is Ellen Frauman. It'll be a great finish. Grable and Frauman and Kristen Nowidy. And they will finish that way. Jenny Grable, for the third straight year, wins the 100-yard breaststroke. 104.67, her time.
Wow, that's pretty exciting. 104, that's her lifetime best in the state meet. Here she is reaching forward. She has it above the water recovery too. She really went out after it this time, and she's worked really hard on her turns, and that has been a weakness of her stroke. She's more of a 150-meter swimmer, which is the Olympic distance, but she's worked really hard on her turns, and it's really starting to pay off.
Second, Jenny Grable wins the 100-yard breaststroke. We'll be back with a 400 free relay after this timeout on Sports Channel. 11 events are completed at the 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships, New Trier Natatorium. And the final results from the 100-yard breaststroke. Event number 11 on the day, Karen Rancourt from Libertyville, Pam Rosansky from Lake Forest High School, Deidre Geisler from Palatine, Elk Grove Village's Anne-Marie Perry in ninth place, Amy Munns, the freshman from St. Charles, Sarah Stevens from Urbana High School, a strong performance. The junior wins the consolation meet. The top six, Kate McMillan. She's from Cary Grove. Aurora Rosaries, Misty Lorich, Brittany Klein of Crystal Lake Central. Kristen Nowida, just as expected, New Trier High School number three. Ellen Fromm in number two. She is from Deerfield High School. A fine performance from her, 105.29. The winning time for Jenny Grable, her third straight championship in this 100-yard breaststroke event. 1 minute, 4 seconds, 67 one-hundredths. Jenny Grable, again the state champion for New Trier High School. And now she gets to come back next year and do the Lisa Cool, try to make it four straight wins in her particular event, this being the 100-yard breaststroke. A great day for Jenny Grable.
Well, she's not finished yet. She's on the free relay, so she gets to come back in about 5 minutes and swim again. Same with Kristen Neuwider. They're both on the free relay.
So here's the standings after 11 events. Hinsdale Central, 123 points. New Trier with 109.5. Deerfield and West Chicago are done. They are not in the 400-yard freestyle relay, so the 85 and 63 will hold. St. Charles is in the final heat of the freestyle relay, so they will have an opportunity to jump into third place. Here's the situation for first place. With the advantage right there for Hinsdale Central, a fifth place or better, assuming that New Trier would win the championship, Bruce, would still give the title to the Red Devils for the third straight year.
That's exactly right. And so it becomes critical that Hinsdale has safe relay starts and tries to finish ahead of New Trier. What I used to tell the kids is be slow off the blocks, but just swim like crazy once you get in that water, and the rest will take care of itself.
The 400-yard freestyle relay, this is the consolation. As they are underway, I'll run you through the grids. At the top of your screen, in lane two, Pekin High School. Homewood Flossmoor is in lane three. In lane four, Peoria Richwood. Lane five, Hoffman Estates. Lane six is Barrington and LaGrange Lions High School. The young ladies in lane seven right now seem to be among the leaders with the lane three team from Homewood Flossmoor. Homewood Flossmoor gets the kick first from the first young lady in second place. Hoffman Estates, third place in lane seven, LaGrange Lions High School.
This is a pretty exciting event, I think. And kids look forward to this event. Lots of swimming fast. They know it's the end of the meet. Nothing to hold back for, nothing to wait for. This is it.
And for a lot of these young ladies, it marks the end of their career, so they definitely want to go out with a bang.
Certainly their high school career. Many of these ladies are swimming in college. But there's a lot of young talent here. One of the things I like about this year's state meet is there's a mixture of veterans and some really talented freshmen and sophomores coming up. It's really exciting.
Homewood Flossmoor in lane three, holding the lead. As the second 50 for Homewood Flossmoor coming now on their second swimmer. Gaining in lane five, Hoffman Estates. Also strong on the outside, Pekin High School.
And you can see that Hoffman Estates is starting to pick up in the blue cap there. And the spread is not nearly as much. In fact, it almost caught up completely. Many coaches will put their slowest swimmer third, and others will counter that strategy by putting their fastest swimmer third, and it makes the change happen that much more dramatically.
So we'll watch it. Here we are on the third swimmer. Four swimmers, 100 yards each, here in the 400-yard freestyle relay, the final event of the afternoon, the 1992 IHSA Girls Swimming and Diving Championships.
And Hoffman State has taken the lead now.
They kick it at a split time of 2:15.62. Second place at 2:16.65 in lane three, Homewood Flossmoor.
And the fastest qualifier last night was Peoria Richwoods in lane four. And they look like they're sixth right now.
Yeah,
we'll see what happens.
They
with
were,
this
Bruce. Thing.
And we'll see what happens with the final swimmer.
That we are ready for now. Kicking off first in lane five, Hoffman Estates. In lane three, Homewood Flossmoor. In lane six, Barrington. Peoria Richwood still, as you mentioned, in sixth place.
And finally just getting into the picture there.
As they are moving in, cutting it up time-wise, but not any distance as of yet. The field getting closer as they are ready to reach the last 50. In lane five, 309.80 the split time. Hoffman Estate still in the lead. A 2 second lead over Homewood Flossmoor as they kick it in to make the final turn. Lane five, your clear cut leader, Hoffman Estates. The top of your screen, lane three, Flossmoor coming in strong. And as they touch, it's Hoffman Estates. 3 minutes, 38 seconds, 0.25. Second place goes to Homewood Flossmoor. Third place in lane seven, LaGrange Lions High School.
Yeah, interestingly enough, if Hoffman Estates had done that last time, they would have been in the final instead of the consolation final. It's good for those girls to know that. And you can see the finish here. The kick is hard. It's another 100-yard freestyle, and outclassing that field by a lot. They're over a body length. And as I mentioned, if they had done that time last night, they would have been able to be in the finals instead of the consolation finals.
And
a lot to be proud of.
And you talk about the finals. Here it is, the 400-yard freestyle, the state record set by Oak Park River Forest High School in 1989 and 90. We run it down, the final race of the afternoon. Lake Park in lane two. River Forest in lane three. Hinsdale Central won this event last year. They are in lane four. They had the fastest qualifying time. St. Charles High School looking for that move into third place in lane five. New Trier needs a wonderful performance from their four swimmers in lane six. And in lane seven, Naperville Central High School. Hinsdale Central, we mentioned, New Trier needs to win. Hinsdale Central didn't just a fifth or better, but you know, as a swimming coach who's won many championships, the pride of these young ladies, they want to do one thing. They want to go out with a clear-cut victory in this final race, don't they?
Exactly. The coaches will say, take it easy on those starts, swim fast, but they want to win. They're so competitive. They'd love to win, and they won't take any chances, but they'll swim their hearts out in between the walls.
Seven straight titles in the 80s, an amazing feat here at New Trier High School. Three is a good start if Hinsdale Central kicks it in again today. And from the young swimmers we've seen on this fine team, they could come back and challenge for years to come.
Well, they've got good coaching. They've got a good talent base. Hinsdale Central is a fine high school and fine tradition, too. Nice start here. And you can see that St. Charles is challenging in lane three.
Hinsdale Central, your leader at the first split, 53.39. They were in the number one spot at the turn. Second place, your lane three that you mentioned, River Forest. Third place, New Trier High School. But right now, New Trier falling back, and Hinsdale Central in the lead. This the second 50 yards for Hinsdale Central High School. Natalie Larrick, the swimmer, the number two swimmer for Hinsdale Central and the Red Devils.
You have to remember that Hinsdale Central qualified with a time 5 seconds faster than everybody else last night. They are the class of the field here, and they are going to finish strong. We know that. The added incentive of being state champions, too.
And as you mentioned, look at the red cap in the water first again. In lane four, Hinsdale Central. They lost Greta Stephenson, who won the 200-yard freestyle, but they still have many more in the stable, and they're coming out strong today, trying to cap off a state championship with a clear-cut victory in the 400-yard freestyle relay, building a decent margin on lane three, Oak Park River Forest.
And here's Colleen Smith. She's third here. She's quite a swimmer. Backstroker, freestyler. She's been an anchor for this team the last couple years, and I know they're going to miss her next year, but she's finishing up with some real class.
A good battle in lanes five and six, St. Charles and New Trier. Looking at moving up in the standings, New Trier obviously going to lose their opportunity here to finish in first place, bearing a disqualification, but
St. Charles chasing Nutrier, doing so in the water also. Naperville Central coming in touching last right now as we move another swimmer into the water.
The Hinsdale has a little added incentive. They weren't far off the state record last night, and as much as they don't want to get disqualified, they want to give those girls a shot at the state record.
Indeed, that is the case.
27 seconds away from it.
304.93, 307.83 in lane three for Oak Park River Forest. The state record is 331.41. Oak Park River Forest, of all people.
Yep.
But the Hinsdale Central Red Devils are going to cap off the 1992 Girls Swimming and Diving State Championship with a win in the final event of the day, the 400-yard freestyle relay. Hinsdale Central goes out with pride.
Yep, a lot of class, smile on their face, mission accomplished. I'm sure that's the way they feel. They had quite a weekend.
Nutrier finishes in the number three spot, finishing in second place, Oak Park River Forest. The Red Devils have reason to cheer. There you see the final times, 332.60. It was a 332.09 last night in qualifying for Hinsdale Central. Second place, Oak Park River Forest. And in lane seven, Naperville Central gets the five spot. In lane five, St. Charles High School, 337.37. They finish in fourth place. Fourth place gets them 22 points in the relay. We'll add up the totals, wrap things up. Here from Nutrier High School, the Hinsdale Central Red Devils, your state champs. So our last event of the day, the 400-yard freestyle relay, your state champions. In the 400-yard freestyle relay and in the overall team competition, the young ladies from Hinsdale Central High School. What a performance by those young ladies today. They win it for the third straight year, 155 points gained. Nutrier comes in a strong second place, 133.5. And as we mentioned, St. Charles does the job to move up into the third place spot, 95 points. Deerfield and Oak Park River Forest just 1 point separating 4 and 5.
First three get trophies. That's the goal of most of these teams as they start their season.
And some great individual performances. Ann Canfie, a state record in the 200-yard IM, a 500 free victory, her second win in that event. Lisa Cool, the 200 free, the 100 fly, she wins it for the fourth straight time. J.J. Bontranger from Naperville, she dominated the sprints. Bruce, Jenny Grable, as always, dominated in the 100-yard breast, her third straight title. And a freshman, Hannah Shin, wins the diving competition.
What a meet it's been. It's been a perfect blend of youth and experience all in one, and it's a great meet. And you see this St. Charles team coming up, and they're starting to challenge now. It's not just Nutrier and Hinsdale. St. Charles, Lake Forest, Oak Park, Naperville Central, they're beginning to start challenging and could see the beginning of the end of some of this domination.
And a fine performance by those young ladies from St. Charles High School, led by Gretchen Vordeen. And Gretchen's got a friend with a half haircut right next to her.
Yeah.
She actually talked somebody else into it. Indeed, the SC on the back of her head. Dennis Rodman would be proud. Is that St. Charles, or could that be a tribute to Sports Channel?
I think it's St. Charles.
Well, you know, either way, a fine performance today by St. Charles High School. And there they are, Nutrier, nothing to be ashamed of. They came and conquered the events they were supposed to, but in the end, the Central girls just a little bit too deep. But Nutrier High School once again takes the number two spot in the state of Illinois.
That's a happy group. They've worked awful hard last year. I know that when they walked out of here a year ago, they set their sights on this state meet this year, and worked really hard to achieve their goal. The team performance stayed the same, but they're absolutely a better swimming team than they were a year ago.
Jenny Grable, a fine performance. She will come back, try to get a fourth straight title in the 100-yard breaststroke. And we saw the fine performance of her teammates. It really is a dynasty here in New Trier High School in suburban Winnetka, Illinois. Seven titles in the 80s. They continue to be among the best.
Tony Harper getting the Coach's Award, and he'll make sure the girls get to take the team trophy. They deserve it.
Runners up in 1992, New Trier High School. 133.5 points. Fine performance this afternoon. And now the long-awaited award giving to the Red Devils for the third straight year. They capture the state title, Hinsdale Central. They did exactly what they needed when it came down to the big relay. They won the first place, took the 32 points in that event after the diving, and they never looked back, Ruth.
No, and they are a very classy organization. Carol Bobo has molded them into a fine group of young women. They know how to win with class. Indeed, they know how to lose with class. Today, they are winners. You can tell by the smiles on their faces. Nice job again, Carol.
Third straight state championship for Carol Bobo and her young ladies from Hinsdale Central High School. Congratulations indeed goes to that fine swimming team. The moment they've been waiting for. Put it in the trophy case next to 1990 and next to 1991. 155 points today as they move the trophy and avoid getting it wet. Now that's an art right there.
Yeah. It'll get wet.
There it goes. The celebration. Hinsdale Central, they're getting used to this though, aren't they?
You never get used to it. It's always a thrill. I know Carol's really thrilled. Told me before the meet that she's going to have another baby in April, and I guess this is kind of a baby bath, not a baby shower.
Bruce enjoyed it this afternoon, a fine day indeed of girls swimming and diving here at New Trier High School. At this time, we'd like to thank some of the people at the Illinois High School Association who made this Illinois State Championship event on Sports Channel possible. The executive director is H. David Fry, the associate executive director, Donald Robinson, assistant executive directors, James Flynn, Ola Bundy, Martin Hickman, and Susan Hendrickson. And more special thanks to Lee Kinnicky, the meet manager, Bill Wolf, the meet director, and Emily Rolene for statistical support. Our next IHSA event on Sports Channel will be the 1992 IHSA Boys Football Championships. Live on Friday, starts with Class 1A at 10 a.m., 1A, 2A, and 3A, live right here Friday afternoon. This meet has been produced and directed by Dave Turner. The graphics coordinator is Joe Groove. Remote facilities were provided by Trio Video of Chicago. Our executive producer is Greg Bowman. For Bruce Woodbury, I'm Mike Goldberg saying goodbye for now. The preceding has been an exclusive presentation of Sports Channel. Stay tuned for the Sports Channel report. That's coming up next.